I am Girish Garg, assistant professor in School of Finance and Commerce. Today we start the correlation analysis. Then the first of all, the question arrives, what is the correlation? The correlation measures the association between two or more variables. And with the help of the correlation, we want to find out whether the two variables are associated or related. If they are associated or related, then how they are associated and related, whether they moving in the same direction or they moving in opposite direction. If they moving in the same direction, then we can say the variable have the positive correlation. If the variable moving in opposite direction, then we can say, or the variable have the inverse relationship, then we can say the variable have the negative correlation. And we will discuss all in this in detail in this video lecture. We will cover the following topic in this video lecture. The first, the question answer by the correlation. When we talk about the correlation, then what type of question that arise in your mind and what will be the answer. Then the scatter plot, we can represent the correlation analysis with the help of the scatter plot diagram. That is the graphical method to represent the correlation between the two variables. Then we have taken the example through which we have represented that with the help of the scatter plot diagram. Then the correlation coefficient, when we talk about the correlation coefficient, that is the Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation, that is represented by small r. Whenever we use the small r in statistics, that represent the Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation. Then the other kind of correlation, and the at the end the factor affecting the correlations. When we talk about the variables, then in our course we have to deal with the simple correlation. The simple correlation means we have given only the two variables. If we have given more than two variables, and if we have to find out the association, then how the variable are related and how the more than two variables are associated, then it come under the multiple correlation. But I'm not covering the multiple correlation in this video lecture. I will restrict myself only to the simple correlation where we deal with only the two variables. Then if we talk about the, if we are given the two variables, then we have to find out how they are related. Does one increase as the other increase, or one decrease the other decrease, then they moving in the same direction. Like if we can say the variable x and y, if the value of x increase, then value of y also increase, then they moving in the same direction. And if we have taken the case second, the if the value of x decrease, the value of y also decrease, then also they moving in the same direction. Then the variable have the positive correlation. The another, does one increase as other decrease, or vice versa, one decrease as the other increase. If we have take the, there are the two variable x and y. If the value of x increasing while the corresponding value of y decreasing, or vice versa, then we can say the variable have the negative correlation. And how can we get a numerical measure of the degree of correlation? Then we can get the numerical value with the help of the Karl Pearson coefficient correlation. There are the various methods, the graphical method as well as the numerical method to measure the correlation. When we talk about the graphical method, then we can represent it with the help of the scatter diagram. And when we talk about the numerical method, then there are the methods that is called the Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation and the rank correlation and various other methods. And here we discuss only to the graphical method in this slide. Then the SK scatter diagram or scatter graph graphically depict the relationship between two variables in a two-dimensional space. Because if we have to represent with the help of the diagram, then we have only the two axes, the vertical axis and the horizontal axis. The usually we can take the dependent variable on the vertical axis and the independent variable on the horizontal axis. And the vertical axis also known as the y-axis, and the horizontal axis also known as the x-axis. And here you can check, we have given on the vertical axis the average number of alcoholic drink per week, and the second on the horizontal axis we have given the average hour of video games per week. then you can check the your positive relationship between the average number of alcoholic drink per week and the average hour of video games per week. As the average hour of the video game per week increase, then it will lead to increase the value of the average number of alcoholic drink per week. Then you can say these are the directly associated the value of the one variable increase, then value of other variable also increase, and it is moving in upward direction. And we can represent this with the help of the scatter plot diagram. Slide, you can check we have taken the two variable, the exam score that we have taken on the vertical axis, and the average hour of video game per week that we have taken on the horizontal axis. Then you can check there are the inverse relationship between exam score and the average hour of video game per week. As the student is spending more and more hour on video game, then there may be chance the student score less marks in the exam. And if the student devoting the less number of hour on the video game, then there is a chance the student score the good marks in the exam. Then the inverse relationship between these two variable, and it is represented with the help of the scatter plot diagram. You can check here that is the downward direction. That's why it represents the exam score and the average hour of video games per week have a negative correlation. Now we have taken the example, does smoking cigarette increase systolic blood pressure? Plotting number of cigarettes smoked per day against the systolic blood pressure, then fairly moderate relationship, and relationship is positive, that we see in the next slide. Then you can check here in this slide, the smoking cigarette in a day that come on the horizontal axis, and the BP, the blood pressure that come under the vertical axis. Then you can check here the positive relationship between the BP and the smoking cigarette number of cigarettes smoked in a day. As the number of cigarettes smoked in a day increase, then there is more chance of the high BP. And the positive relationship between this, and we have taken the line of fit to better represent this the scatter plot diagram, and it depicts the positive relationship between these two variables. What type of relationship? Relationship is moderate but real. When we talk about the relationship between the blood pressure and the number of cigarettes smoked in a day, then the relationship is moderate but real. And why do we have care about relationship? What would conclude if there were no relationship? First, what if the relationship were near perfect? And the last, what if the relationship were negative? On the basis of that relationship, we can making the policy, the government draft their policy, they can taken the decision, they base will take the base decision on the basis of that association. That's why these type of associations are required. If the variable are associated, that is the first step, then we have to go to the second step, we have to stabilize the cause and effect relationship. If we are able to stabilize the cause and effect relationship, then we can predict the value of dependent variable with the help of independent variable. Then it is very crucial to know what type of relationship between the variables, and it will help in the policy formulation and the means decision making. Then here we have taken the heart disease and the cigarette. Data on heart disease and cigarette smoking in 21 developed countries we have given. Data have been rounded for computation convenience. We have rounded the data, and when we have rounded the data, then that not affected our result. Then we can see the data in the next slide. Then you can check here we have given the data. In the column number 1, we have given the country that represent country number 1 to country number 21, 1 to 21. Then we have given the number of cigarettes smoked in a day at 11.9, corresponding to the serial number of country. Then we have given the mortality rate in the column number 3, corresponding to the serial number of country. Then the data which we have given in the previous slide, we can represent that with the help of both the graphical method as well as the numerical method. Then first we can find out the correlation between the data between the two variables, that is number of the cigarette smoke in a day and mortality rate out of 10,000 with the help of the graphical method through a scatter plot diagram. And after that, we will do the same question with the help of the numerical method that we call the Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation. Then here you can check in the next slide, we have taken the mortality goes on the ordinate axis. And why? Because that is ordinate axis, that is y axis, because the mortality that depend on the number of cigarettes smoke in a day. Because we have to take the independent variable on the horizontal, vertical axis. Then the cigarette consumption on the x axis. Why? Because we have to take the independent variable on the x axis or horizontal axis. And the cigarette consumption in a day, that are the independent variable. That's why we have taken that on the horizontal axis. Then what does each dot represent? Each dot represents the corresponding value, the corresponding value of mortality when there is the number of cigarette consumption. And for that, we have taken the best fitting line, including for clarity, so that on the basis of that, we can take the decision what type of correlation they have, whether they have the low positive correlation, or the moderate positive correlation, or high positive correlation, or perfectly positive correlation. With the help of the fitting line, we can find out, and it will provide the clarity, and we will check that in the next slide. Now you can check in this slide, we have taken that in the mortality rate out of 10,000 on the vertical axis, and the cigarette consumption per adult per day on the horizontal axis, and that is the fitting line, this one, and that is the dotted point. The corresponding value of one variable is with respect to the other variable. Then you can check they move in the upward direction, that's why there is a positive correlation. And what type of positive correlation? Because on the all the dotted point that near about to the fitting line, then we can say the highly positive correlation between these two variables. Now what does this scatter plot show? Then as smoking increase, so does the heart disease also increase, which lead to mortality. Relationship looks strong because all the dotted point that near about to the line of fit, then not all data point on line, but they are near about. This give us the residual or error of prediction, which we'll discuss later on. There are some other factor that lead to the mortality. And the smoking cigarette is not only the one factor. There are the various factor, but we can say due to the smoking cigarette, it will lead to the chance of the heart disease, and which convert to the mortality. Correlation. The relationship between two variables, because we have deal with simple correlation only. Measure with a correlation coefficient. Most properly seen correlation coefficient, that is the Pearson product movement correlation, which we will deal in the next slide. Type of correlation, the positive correlation, the high value of x tend to associated with high value of y. As x increase, y also increase. Negative correlation, high value of x tend to associated with low value of y. As x decrease, y increase, and vice versa. No correlation, whatever change in the value of one variable, there is no change in the corresponding value of the other variable. No consistent tendency for value on y to increase or decrease as x increase. That is, we can say there is no correlation or the zero correlation. These are the characteristics. A measure of degree of relationship, the correlation coefficient, measure the degree of relationship, while the regression that measure the nature of relationship, and the value lie between plus 1 to minus 1. The coefficient of correlation cannot take the value more than plus 1 or cannot take the value less than minus 1. Sign refer to the direction. If there is plus sign, then it indicate to the positive correlation. If there is a negative sign, that indicate to negative correlation. And that based on the covariance. Measure of degree to which large score on x go with large score on y, and a small score of x go with small score of y. Think of it as variance, but with two variables instead of one does not mean that mean then we have to find out whenever we have to find out the coefficient of covariance then the formula the covariance of x and y divided by the standard deviation of x multiplied by standard deviation of y then if we have to find out the value of correlation coefficient then we need the value of these three variables first the covariance of x and y second the standard deviation of series x and the third the standard deviation of series y then you can check here the range of correlation that lie between plus 1 to minus 1 the plus 1 that represent perfect positive correlation as one event increase the second exactly increase in the same proportion if have then it has the linear relationship and which have a linear line which have the angle of 45 degree and the positive correlation that they are moving in the same direction as one even increase the second sometime increase then but there are maybe the linear relationship or the curvilinear if the linear relationship then it have the angle of more than 45 degree or less than 45 degree and the curvilinear then we can find out some type of curve and the zero correlation mean whatever change in the one variable it will not lead to change in the corresponding value of the second variable and the negative correlation that is the downward sloping the direction that is downward if change in the one variable if the value of the one variable increase then sometime the value of other variable decrease then it may be the linear or non-linear if it is linear then it has the degree that is the greater than angle greater than 45 degree or less than 45 degree or it may be the curvilinear and the perfect negative correlation that is downward sloping and it must have the angle of 45 degree then these are the range of the correlation and the value vary between plus 1 to minus 1 now the covariance how can we find out the covariance the variance of x that equal to the summation under the bracket x minus max bar bracket close the square divided by n minus 1 the n minus 1 that is representing the degree of freedom and that represents the total number of observation in this range of x or the pair of observation in both this range and the x that depend the observation which we have given and the x bar that is the mean value of the series x then the formula of the covariance of x and y that is the summation under the bracket x minus max bar bracket close and bracket open y minus y bar bracket close and divided by n minus 1 how this work and why we will discuss on the on we will discuss in the upcoming slide when would the coefficient of covariance between x and y be large and positive large and negative large and positive then it will lead to the positive correlation large and negative then it will lead to the negative correlation now we have take the same question which we have discussed in the previous slide and here we have find out the value with the help of the Karl-Pearson coefficient of correlation then first we need the value of the covariance of x and y then in the column number 1 we have given the serial number of country 1 to 21 then in the column number 2 we have given the number of cigarettes smoked in a day and we represent that with the help of the variable x and the column number 3 that is the mortality rate and we represent that with the help of y then we can find out the mean value of these three x how can we find out the sum of all the observation divided by number of observation the sum of all these value divided by 21 then we can get the 5.95 the same way we can find out the mean value of 3y the sum of all these 21 value divided by 21 then we can find out the 14.52 then here now we can find out the deviation taken from the deviation of the 3x taken from the actual mean then 11 minus my 5.95 that is 5.05 then 9 minus my the x bar that is 5.95 then we getting the deviation value of 3x of all the 21 country the same way we can find out the deviation value of the 3y of all 21 country that is the 26 minus 14.52 that is 11.48 the same way we can find out the Davis value of other country. Then in the last column, we can find out the product of these two deviations, deviation of series x and the deviation of series y. The 5.05 multiplied by 11.48, and we can find out all this, and at the end we have to done the total, that equal to 222.42. And you can check, we can find out the standard deviation. How can we find out the standard deviation? That is the formula, the standard deviation of 3x, that equal to the square root, the sum of x square divided by n. The sum of x square, that is sum of the deviation, sum of square deviation taken from actual mean divided by total number of observation. And we have to find out this, and that is the standard deviation of 3x, that is 2.33, and the standard deviation of 3y, that is 6.69. Now we have all the three value which we are required to find out the value of r, because we required the covariance of 3x and y, and first, and second, we required the standard deviation of 3x, and the third, the standard deviation of 3y. Now we have all the three value. In the next slide, we compute the value of r. Then we can find out the covariance. That is the formula, the sum of x minus x bar under bracket y minus y bar, that equal to 222.44 divided by n minus 1, and that is total number of observation, 21 minus 1, that is 20. Then we can find out the value of covariance, 11.12. Now this is the formula to find out the value of r. That equal to covariance of x, 3, x and y divided by the standard deviation of x multiplied by standard deviation of y. And now we can find out the covariance x and y, that is 11.12, standard deviation of x, that is 2.33, the standard deviation of y, that is 6.69. Now we put the value of r, that is covariance x and y divided by the standard deviation of x multiplied by standard deviation of y, that is 11.12 divided by 2.33 multiplied by 6.69. 11.12 divided by 15.59, that equal to 0.713. Then the value of correlation, that is 0.713. This is positive. Why? Because it has the positive sign. If sign were negative, then it has the inverse relation. What would it mean? It has the inverse relation. What would alter the degree of relationship? Yes, it will degree. It will not alter the degree of relationship. Now here we talk about the other method for calculating the value of correlation. Then we can use the z-score method, in which we can calculate the value of r, that is equal to the summation of z value of x and the z value of 3y divided by n minus 1. And the computation rho score method, then we use this formula to find out the value of correlation. The n, the summation of x y minus the summation of x multiplied with summation of y divided by under root the under the bracket n multiplied by the summation of x square minus the summation of x ka whole square bracket close, and then the bracket open n multiplied by summation of y square minus the summation of y ka whole square and bracket close. With the help of that, we can find out the value of r. Spearman rank order correlation coefficient, that represented by RSP, used with two ring ordinal variable, uses the same Pearson formula. If we have given these two things, the attractiveness, and we have given the rank and the symmetry, that also we have given the rank, then we can find out the correlation with the help of the same Pearson formula, that equal to 0.77. It indicates the positive relationship between these two variables.